Hello everyone, my name is Jerry from the Toast Customer Training Team, and in this video, we are going to cover the main actions that you should take when closing out of Toast at the end of day. Before using these features, you will need to complete some setup within Toast Web to best meet your restaurant's needs. However, throughout this video, we will link some helpful resources to ensure that you are set up for success. Let's dive in. To access the shift review, we'll need to navigate to the terminal menu. From the order screen, navigate to the left-hand corner where we can see that arrow. That'll allow us to navigate back to that terminal menu, navigate to My Account, and select Shift Review. The shift review is an optional end-of-day task that walks hourly employees through all the steps that need to be completed prior to clocking out and closing out their shifts. On the shift review, we'll see two sections. The left pane is going to include the shift review report. The shift review report also provides employees with an overview of their sales transactions, tip amounts, and other end-of-shift information. In the shift review report on the left-hand side, we'll be able to see information throughout an employee's shift. Employees with certain permissions can view their own personal sales data and payment data in this report. We'll have a section, employee account, cash in hand, means cash payments that were taken, and cash is owed to the restaurant. Scrolling down to tips and fees earned, employees can see non-cash tips, such as credit card tips and gratuities, as well as tips declared. As we continue to scroll, we are going to see information about the employee's entire shift, including total discounts, total cash payments, total payments, and my guest report. The guest report includes information about the total guests served and an average spend per guest. On the right-hand side, we'll see the shift review steps. The shift review steps will include a list of steps an employee must complete prior to clocking out. When a step is completed, a green check mark will appear next to that step. Step number one is to close checks. Employees will be able to see if they have any unpaid or unclosed checks, as well as closed checks. Employees must close all checks in order to complete their shift review. If any checks are not closed, they can select closed checks. If we see that green check mark, that means we're good to move on to the following step. Declaring cash tips refers strictly to cash tips, not credit card tips. This step will only be shown if it's enabled within Toast Web and if the employee is marked as a tipped employee. We'll go ahead, declare those cash tips, and select declare to move on to the following step. Step number three, we have reconcile cash and tips. Again, employees will turn in any cash in hand and collect any non-cash tips and gratuity in cash if relevant. Step number four is clocking out. An employee has the opportunity to clock out of their shift or clock out and start a new shift. Employees also have the option to reopen a shift review if we need to make any edits by selecting Edit, Yes, Make Edits, with the correct permissions or with the manager passcode, we'll be able to make those edits. We'll select Reopen Shift. Again, employees can also reopen the shift within the current work week to recalculate its data. When a shift is reopened, previous cash and tip entries will be overwritten, meaning that you will have to turn in your cash and collect your tips again. All of this depends on those manager permissions on what we're able to do here. Once that looks good, we'll proceed to closing out our shift. If an employee is unable to clock out, a manager can complete a shift review for their employees. Managers can now edit and adjust their staff's time entries from the POS utilizing the Review Employee Shifts function, which is located under Manager Activities. Navigating to Manager Activities and selecting Review Employee Shifts. Managers can now adjust their shifts and employee shifts and clock in and clock out times directly from this screen. Now let's discuss how to adjust an active shift. An active shift means an employee has not closed their shift. If an employee is clocked in, the manager can adjust their clock in time. By selecting their clock in over on the right-hand side is how we're able to make that adjustment. However, please take note that no clock out adjustment is shown because the employee has not clocked out yet. as well as declare tips button will not be shown until the employee has closed their shift. To clock out an employee from the screen, tap on the clock out button. If the manager clocks out the employee, they will be redirected to the shift review screen and prompted to close the shift before clocking out. To reopen a shift, the manager will tap Remove next to the clockout section and save those changes. Then the shift will be moved to the active shift section. Now let's talk about the closeout day. To view the closeout day, start by selecting Closeout Day located under Manager Activities from the Toast POS main menu. The Closeout Day page is an optional feature that provides you with an audit report on the current status of all checks and employee activity. This is not required to be manually carried out each night to turn the day over in the system. Toast will carry out these functions automatically for each restaurant on a nightly basis, so manual intervention is not required. Please take note that Toast will not close any unpaid orders. These will remain open until they are resolved either by being paid or by being voided. So to close out those checks, select View Checks. From the Closeout Day screen, we'll also be able to view all of our employees that are clocked in, any cash drawers that need to be closed, and also we'll have the opportunity to create a deposit. A deposit is cash removed from a restaurant to be deposited in a bank or other financial institution. A cash deposit should be the final cash management operation of the day. After all checks are closed, shift reviews are completed, and all cash drawers are closed, you can use the cash deposit screen to enter in the actual cash amount of the deposit into the Toast platform. To close a cash drawer directly from this page, select Close Drawers, and we'll be redirected to that area. We'll get into that with more detail in just a bit. To create a deposit, we're going to select Create Deposit, and we'll be able to add in our deposits by selecting Add Deposit. On the left-hand side, we'll be able to view the Z report. The Z report is a sales summary that can be printed by an in-store receipt printer when using the closeout date function. If we'd like to change the date of this report, we can simply click into the date and choose the date that we'd like to see. The Z report is also completely customizable. You can configure the information that will display on the Z report by navigating over to Toast Web and navigating to UI options. From this page, we'll also be able to print the report. Keep in mind that printing the report does not turn the day over into the next day. The data updates in real time as sales occur. On this screen, we may also see an auto-resolve button. You can auto-resolve certain issues if you need to close out quickly or want to resolve a large number of issues with the same solution. We may also see an end day button. Open checks must be resolved before you can end the day. In fact, the end day button won't be available until all open checks have been resolved. And you cannot auto-resolve open checks. Another report that is similar to the Z report that we can see on the closeout day screen are service reports. Located under Manager Activities, we'll navigate over to Service Reports. Service Reports provides you with the same data as a Z report, but broken down by the day parts, such as service periods, that are set up for your restaurant. So we'll be able to see those different service periods by selecting this drop-down menu. The Service Period drop-down menu will allow you to filter your sales data to a specific day part, such as breakfast, lunch, dinner, brunch, etc. You can also select Print Report at the bottom of the screen if desired. Depending on your restaurant, you may or may not have a cash drawer that needs closing. The Cash Management section on your device contains all of the cash drawer-related actions that you'll need to manage your cash and balance on a daily basis. Navigate over to Cash Management and select cash drawers. The cash drawers live in three different states: active, open, and closed. If a drawer is in an active state, that means that it is in use and taking payments. An open state means that it is not in use and the drawer is not taking any cash payments, but will accept other types of cash transactions, such as cash in or payout entries. The drawer has not been closed, so the expected balance has not been entered into the POS. And the third state is a closed state, which means the drawer is not taking cash payments or other cash transactions. The bills have been counted, and the actual closing balance has been entered into the POS. You can change the state of cash drawers as needed during the restaurant business hours. And if a drawer has been locked to us, we'll need to close out the cash drawer before we can clock out. To close an active drawer, navigate to the Active Drawer tab and select a drawer to close. Before we close out our drawer, let's talk about some of the buttons over on the right-hand side. The No Sale button is used to open the cash drawer without adding or removing cash. So this is typically used to count your drawer. The Cash In function adds cash into the restaurant. By selecting the Cash In button, that will add cash to an active and open drawer. The Cash Out button is used to remove cash from an active and open drawer. So this is typically done when there is too much cash in the drawers and some needs to be removed to a safe or to another safe location. The Cash Drop button removes cash from an active drawer or open drawer without closing it. New Drawer will allow us, after closing one drawer at the end of the shift, we may need to open another for the start of the next shift. Adjust Starting Balance will allow us to adjust that starting balance. And finally, Close Drawer is what we're going to select to close our drawer. With the correct permissions, we'll be able to see the cash expected. This is the amount that Toast is expecting to see in the drawer. Cash actual is the actual amount that we've counted in the drawer. So maybe we've counted a total of $593. Cash over is letting us know the difference between cash expected and cash actual, and comment allows us to add comments. Count bills is another way that we're able to count our bills within the drawer. Now to close out the drawer, we're simply going to select close drawer, and our drawer has now been closed. Once we close a drawer, we'll be able to see details about that closed drawer in the cash drawer report. Please keep in mind that anytime we close a cash drawer, another drawer will open under active. So if applicable, once we close our cash drawers, now we can move on to clocking out. And also to quickly show us, once we have closed out our drawer, if we navigate back to closeout day, because the drawer has been closed, we will now see the end date button and the auto resolve button. To clock out from the passcode screen, enter in your passcode, select time clock. We'll select the clock out button at the bottom of our screen. This will take us back to the shift review. And once again, once we've completed the steps within the shift review, we'll be able to select clock out and complete our shift review. We'll also have the opportunity to print our shift review. Thank you so much for watching this video. For more information and helpful resources, please make sure to check out Toast Central.